episode 146 of the Craft House Magic Podcast. My name's Ellie and I'm coming to you from Norwich in Norfolk in the UK, and today is the 31st of December. So welcome everybody, I hope you've all had a lovely crafty week since the last time I've spoken to you on Christmas Eve. And I'm here to share all the things that I've been making over the last 7 days. But first of all, I want to wish you all a happy new year for tomorrow, or today if it's already tomorrow. If that makes sense. It's not a good start, is it? Oh dear. Anyway, you can find me as Craft House Magic on a number of social media sites, and I'll leave the links in the description down below. But I have my own website, crafthousemagic.co.uk, where you can find my hand-dyed yarns, handmade project bags, stitch markers, HiyaHiya knitting needles, clover crochet hooks, and also bag making supplies like fabrics and wadding, etc. So today we have knitting. We have some cross stitch, we have some dressmaking, and then I have got an exciting new thing to announce in the shop update, but I'll leave that till the end of the podcast. We have a few makealongs going on in the Ravelry group at the moment. Two of them are finishing this evening, so at the end of December, and that is the Craft House Magic Gift Along 2020 and also the Festive Frenzy 2020. Now, I did say that I was going to close the Mistletoe Kisses Mal at the end of December, but I think I'm going to give you another month because there's a lot of yarn to knit there in those advents. So I think I'm going to give you to the end of January to pop all your entries in before I draw for prizes in there. But I will be drawing prizes for the other two next week, so you've got a couple of extra days. So stick your entries in while you can. So let's get on with the knitting, shall we? I have a finished object. Ta-da! Here they are! A socks I knitted over Christmas. This Christmas, I just needed to relax and just have a plain knit, so I just used my simple top-down sock pattern to knit these. And you can find that pattern in the description bar down below, but I'll also put a link to the videos I've got to how I knit my socks top-down. I've also got some toe-up sock tutorials as well if you're interested in those, and I'll pop links in the description bar down below. This yarn is gorgeous. It is from Austria, and it's called Mally Sock, and it was sent to me by a lovely friend. So thank you ever so much, you know who you are. And it basically says Mally Sock, and this means Christmas edition underneath. And it is made of 75% superwash wool, 25% polyamide, and it is colour, I'm not quite sure what colour it is, you can read the label yourself. But it was sent to me as a lovely gift from Austria. And that's actually the company where the wool comes from originally. Now, this is an unusual yarn because there's 150 grams in this ball. This is what's left of it. And there's 450 metres, which makes it quite a thick 4-ply yarn. But I still went for my normal 2.5 millimeter needles with the 64 stitches because I have quite a tight tension. I think most people normally have a 2.25 millimeter needle for the gauge that I get, but because this yarn is a little bit thicker, it does come up as a really nice tight gauge, and they'll be really durable socks, I think. But it is lovely and squishy. And I just love how this pattern's come out. It's really unusual. And I like where I was decreasing down here, and also for the toes as well. I really like how that sort of does a different pattern as well, and on the heel flap. And because you've got these different colours on every row here, I really like how the slip stitch heel works as well. Really love those. They're going to be Adam's Christmas socks because he really hasn't got many Christmas socks. So I'm going to be knitting him a few pairs so that on next year's Vlogmas he's got more Christmassy socks to wear. So that's those pair finished and ready to wear for next year in his Christmas box. He's not allowed to wear them until next December, I've decided. I haven't actually blocked them properly yet, but they've been sat on the sock blockers for a couple of days so that they've had a bit of a chance to sort of stretch out. But they always look neater when you've given them a bit of a block. A few people ask me whether you need to block socks. You absolutely don't, but I just like to, just because I like how neat they look. And because I do have quite chunky legs myself, even if I stretch the rib out a little bit, it's absolutely fine for me. Adam probably doesn't like it though, because he's got slim legs. But I like to make them neat. Anyway, because I'd got some of this yarn left, I used 90 grams of this yarn for this pair of socks. So I'd got 60 grams left, which isn't enough to knit a pair of socks with a decent sized leg, but I thought I can knit a little Christmas jumper for the Christmas tree for these. So I have started knitting a little Christmas jumper here out of the yarn, and it looks different on both sides. I do like the effect that's occurring here with the sort of shorter rows and a bit of pooling around the neck there. So I've put the stitches on some little stitch markers there just to keep them so that I can pick those up later and knit some little sleeves. I've got to do a little bit more of the body here before I start the ribbon bind off. This is actually another pattern which is called the Dinky Jumper, and it's out of the Matchbox Sweater Project, which was a pattern by Anna Feldman and Jane Lithgow, which was a group of sweaters that I actually have knitted a couple of before. This one's supposed to be striped with lots of different coloured yarns, but I'm just using one colour because it stripes itself. But these two jumpers were also knitted from the same pattern book. This one's probably my favourite one. But those are all in the same pattern set, and that is a paid for pattern. So that's what I've been working on. But I also have another finished object which is also related to little jumpers. Ta-da! So if you watched last week's podcast, you'll know that I'd done about this much of this little jumper, and it's a little polar neck. How cute is that? So this is a different pattern, but this is a free pattern, this one. This one's called The Sweater Ornament by Nina Isaacson. And basically it's a bottom up sweater with some lovely little cables at the front, and actually there's cables on the front and on the back, so it'll look exactly the same both sides. I haven't mentioned, actually, I've got little coat hangers that I use for my little jumpers that I've been knitting. I shall take this one off to show you what it looks like. I picked these up from eBay. If I can find the link, I shall put it in the description bar down below. But I just thought that these were really cute, so that you can hang jumpers on the Christmas tree. Bit fiddly to get into this polar neck one. There we go. Ta-da! I'm obviously obsessed with tiny little jumpers at the moment. So that's what I've been knitting. That's all the knitting I've been working on, I think. So I have my cross stitch to show you next, and I was so close to finishing, but I'm not going to finish it for the end of the year, because obviously today is the last day of the year. I will, however, get it finished over the weekend, so because I'll have finished it before the first podcast of the new year, that counts as well. It is not going to explode because I haven't finished it. I have literally got two more flowers to do up the side, and then these border stitches, which are quite time consuming, to be honest. But I am so pleased that I'm so close to the end, and I am absolutely sure I'll finish that over the weekend. But I'm liking the look of it, and I can't wait to get it framed. I haven't decided yet whether I'll put it behind glass. So normally I just frame things without putting the glass in them if I'm doing cross stitch. But I don't know whether, because I've put so much time into this piece, whether I'm going to get some of that glass that's non-reflective. I shall see. If you have any recommendations of where to get non-reflective glass from in the UK, I'd love to hear them. So that is a pattern by Moira Blackburn, but I'll leave a link where you can get it in the description bar down below, and I am actually stitching it on an 18 count Aida. So I have some dressmaking to show you next. So Barbara, would you like to come through to show everybody? Thank you very much, Barbara. So Barbara is wearing my latest Zadie dress. This is a pattern by Tilly and the Buttons, and it's made for stretch fabric. I've used a jersey which is made up of cotton and elastane, and it was from Fabrics Galore, and it's a gorgeous, gorgeous print, and it is called Watercolour Bouquet, and I absolutely love this print. It is the most pretty, just, it's got all the colours you can imagine. I especially like this little bit of turquoise and the lovely pinks that are in there, and the fact that it's got a nice navy background, because I think that that makes a very flattering garment when it's got a darker background. So the Zadie dress is such a comfortable dress. It's got the massivest pockets you've ever seen in your life. I can literally put an A5 book in there. Let's put my show notes book in there to show you how big it is. You can literally put that A5 book in there. Absolutely brilliant. It is so comfortable, secret pyjamas. When I first made this garment, I did make some modifications to the bust area. So there's sort of princess seams around the bust here. And I give myself a little bit more room so that it wasn't pulling so much around the front of my bust, around the fullest part of my bust. So I did that modification right from the start. And for this one, actually, I decided that the other two versions that I've got were very slightly on the long side because I wanted it to cut right just past my knee so that it would make, I don't know, I've got this, I think that it just is slightly more flattering when it hits you on the narrowest part of your leg, if that makes sense. So I took 2 inches off this one and I really like it. And I used the lengthening and shortening lines on the pattern piece so that I didn't just take the length off the bottom, so that it would be just as wide at the longest edge, if that makes sense. Really pleased with how it looks, and I'm definitely going to make more of these. I'm slightly obsessed with this pattern. This is my third version. So because it's got panels, there's a panel on the front there and also at the sides, you can use different colours of fabric if you want to. And on the first two versions I did that, but because this fabric is just so gorgeous, I thought I'll just have an all over version, which I absolutely love. This is the second version. I've done 3/4 length sleeves, and I've done one version that's a shorter sleeve. But I didn't use the pattern piece that they sort of said as the short sleeve version, because it is very, very short. It sort of comes up right up here and doesn't have a full sleeve that goes under the arm. So what I did is took the longer pattern piece and just chop it off at a sort of t-shirt length that I like. And it's sort of the same length as this t-shirt, I think. I did for the shorter sleeve version, but I thought because it's sort of a more wintry fabric with it being a darker background, I'll do them 3/4 length sleeves. And actually it can be worn most of the year, to be honest, in the UK, because it's quite chilly most of the time. But absolutely love this. What I'll do is when Barbara's taking it off, I'll do a few twirls in the lounge. There's no way I'm going to be doing it in the garden because there's frost everywhere today. It's way too cold to be twirling around in the garden without a coat on. So I'm going to try and do it in the lounge. We still have our Christmas decorations up, so at least there's some pretty decorations around me. I will leave links to all the things I've mentioned in the description bar down below, but I've also, on my blog, I put a little post of the video, of each video I put up, and the show notes are there as well. So last of all, I have the shop update section. And I am so super excited to be announcing that I'm doing some yarn clubs for 2021. They will be running from January to September, and you can purchase them on a month-by-month basis. They will be all new colourways, and they'll be exclusive to the yarn clubs until at least 2022, where I might release some of them as permanent colourways, but you won't be able to get those until 2022. So first of all, I'm doing the mixtape mini set, which is basically a collection of yarns inspired by a collection of songs that I'll put together as a mixtape sort of thing. And I'll also be introducing some sock sets. So those will be inspired by the music from the movies. So we've got the mixtape minis and music from the movie sock sets coming out. So they'll both be available on 4 bases. So you'll be able to get them on 4-ply yarns, on the merino and nylon base, on the Stellina merino and nylon base, and also the BFL and nylon base. So that's all 4-ply yarns, but also a DK merino as well. So for both the minis and the sock sets, you can choose from those 4 bases. For the minis, there'll be 20 gram minis, and for the sock sets, there'll be a 100 gram skein and a 20 gram skein to go with it. I'm not going to do all different sizes because with all those base choices, it's going to be confusing as it is, I think. But if there's enough demand, maybe later on in the year, I might introduce some more choices. So just to keep it nice and simple to start with, we've got the two choices of the mixtape minis and the music from the movie Sock Club available on those four bases. Like I said, there'll be all new colours and there'll be a surprise each month. You won't know what colour you're getting. And I'll give a little explanation as to what the inspiration song is and a little bit about the song as well. I won't be including any extra stitch markers and things. So these will be on the website for January's sets on the 1st of January at 7 p.m. GMT. And they will be available on the website until the 5th of January. Now, I'll put a certain number of sets on the website, and if they sell out before that date, they will obviously show up as sold out, but I will leave them on the website for that period of time. I will be making a list of all the dates where the yarn clubs will be coming up on the website, so that you can put a reminder in your calendar as well, so that you don't miss out on any of them. But if you watch the podcast, you won't miss out on any of them anyway, because I'll make an announcement before they're available. So this Friday's update, the 1st of January at 7 p.m, I'll also be updating some of the HiyaHiya knitting needles as well. Some of them have been out of stock a little while, so that's exciting to get them restocked again. Some of the bamboo needles are still out of stock, but as and when they're updated at the warehouse, I'll get them updated on my website as well. So that's all for this week. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe if you'd like to see more. And of course, Happy New Year! Bye!